Who believes in aliens? Because I believe that they must be aliens. Whether or not they've visited us, it's a different story. Put it this way, I believe that there's other forms of life outside, of our solar system. There's no way, absolutely no way, right, that we can have. Do you know how many billions of planets there are? Billions of universes, billions of solar systems, millions of galaxies there are in this universe. Even in the Milky Way, there's let's just say there's thousands, for argument's sake, solar systems in the Milky Way. Do you know how many other galaxies there are out there? Millions, that have within. So out of all the millions of galaxies, whatever, in it, each of them have thousands, maybe even millions of solar systems that have planets in it. There's no way, right? In this universe, there's only one planet that has the conditions that are right for life. They call it the Goldilocks zone. So we're in the Goldilocks zone right now. It's not too hot, it's not too cold. If we was a certain amount of kilometers or miles too close to the sun, it will be too hot for us. If we were a certain amount of kilometers out, like where Mars is, it will be too cold, whatever in it. Now, obviously, back in the day, like a long time ago, I believe Mars had conditions that were okay for life because that's why it had running water. And allegedly, anywhere that there's running water, there is life. So there's plenty of planets. Do your research, watch videos on YouTube or the science documentary channels, Nat Geo Science or whatever in it. There's plenty of planets right out there, right, that have running water on it or whatever in it. And there's plenty of planets that are within the Goldilocks zone. Not too hot, not too cold. So there's no way, right? Out of the millions of planets that there are out there's only one place that there's life, which is here. No way. There's no, I don't believe there's any aliens or anything like that or other forms of life in this solar system, innit? Well, we've got 9, 10, 11 planets, whatever, innit? They would have known already, innit? That's cool. But beyond the solar system, even within this galaxy, the Milky Way, there must be other planets that have forms of life, right? Whether they're flying spaceships or driving cars or doing horse tranquilizer, there's still other forms of life, no matter how basic or complex they are, isn't it? So basically, I've watched a couple programs and they're saying that there's many Earth-like planets scattered across the universe, scattered across even the Milky Way, and they're exactly like ours, they got the right conditions for life, right? They even look possibly even look similar to Earth. There's actually planets they call super Earths, and it's basically a planet that's just like Earth, a rocky planet that has predominantly water on it, but it's like the size of Jupiter. That's it. They said they got plenty of planets that are called like super Earths, and they're pretty much the same as our planet. They're like Earth. They're like a bit like Mars. Obviously, Mars had water, but it dried up or whatever, innit? They're pretty much like Earth, rocky, but with water on it. They have an atmosphere, all that bullshit, but it's just a bigger version, maybe similar to the size of Saturn or Jupiter. But yeah, it's just a bigger version of Earth, and they call it a super Earth, whatever. And so I think, man's deep on them science planet programs, you know, that, trust me, man's into that stuff. Like, I've always been into science and the cosmos and, you know, and them thing there, and it, like, I will go fucking, man will go down to the fucking planetarium on my own, you know, the planetarium in South London in Greenwich, the Royal Observatory and the planetarium next to it. I will go there by myself. Listen, I'm gonna be down in London. What? A couple of days time, I will take my little sister there. Use it as an excuse to get, using it as an excuse to to go to the planetarium. Yeah. Actually, you know what? With all this COVID-19, I don't know. Have they not opened up the cinemas yet? I'm not too sure if they open up the cinemas. So if they haven't opened up the cinemas, then the planetarium is probably closed anyway. Fucking idiots. See, my man said, to put it simply, do you think people look similar to us? No, I don't think they will look like us in it. I actually watched a program about this. So a man said, to put it simply, do you think people who look like us reside on another planet? I will say no. And I saw a program about this, right? And they said, out of all of everyone's like imagination, right? Like, why do people who create movies about aliens, why do they have a similar look to humans? Why do they always have two arms, two legs, and a head, right? Why do they have a similar body to humans? Eh? Like, our planet has a variety of different looking animals. Yeah? So why do they make aliens have to look similar to us? Again, two arms, two legs, fucking head, two eyes, and a mouth. Yeah. Why not a creature with like tentacle arms and shit like that, innit? And I thought to myself, you know what? Yeah, if they were aliens or whatever, even if they were as advanced as us, why do they have to even look similar to us? Yeah, why can't it just be a fucking a ball of sludge or something like that? Or what's that fucking film called? Flubber. Why can't they look like Flubber or something like that? Yeah, why do they have to look humanoid? Yeah, so yeah, and on another planet, I would say, yeah, if they do have intelligent life, they don't have to look like us. They don't have to be like these creatures that wear long gowns and big heads so you can see their brain and they got two eyes and stuff. No, they'll just look totally different. I don't know what the fuck they look like. I reckon aliens probably look like, you know, bacteria when they look at bacteria underneath the microscope. I reckon that's how aliens probably look. Yeah, all creepy looking and that or whatever. And